In 10th problem, what he has given is limit extends to 0, 1 minus cos cube x by sin x, sin x, cos x. What is the answer he is asking? Here, what you have to understand is the point here, the logic inside this problem is we write as 1 cube minus cos cube x. So the examiner intention is whether you can write this one as 1 cube or not. Whether you can able to write the formula of a cube and b cube or not. Here x into sin x into cos x. Sin x into cos x. Sin x into cos x. So here what I am going to is, I am going to apply the formula of a cube minus b cube. You all of you know the formula of a cube minus b cube. A minus b into this is a, this is b. So that formula I am writing here. Limit extends to 0. Limit extends to 0. A cube minus b cube means what? A minus b. A minus b into a square. Here a means 1. A square. A square plus ab. 1 into cos x. A square plus ab plus b square. A square plus ab plus b square. By, I am going to write this x as x square. You may ask one question, sir, why you wrote this as x square? Because I already told, I am telling from last two problems. Whenever sine, tan, sine inverse, tan inverse are there, you should be careful. Here, multiplying and dividing with x. Why? I have formula sine x by x. Limit extends to 0. Sine x by x formula, you know, it is 1. For that reason, in place of x, multiplying the numerator and denominator with x, this becomes 1. Into cos x into cos x. Now this became what? 1 only. This became 1 only. Now you all of you know in the beginning, the first, second problem also and first problem also I told you, limit extends to 0, 1 minus cos x by x square. 1 minus cos x by x square is same as what? 1 by 2. So these are all very very important formulas which you have to remember. Limit extends to 0, 1 minus cos x by x square is equal to 1 by 2. We use this formula for the previous problems. So next, remaining is what? Cos 0, 1. Cos square 0, 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 1 by cos 0, 1. So finally, what the answer I am going to get is? The answer what I am going to get is 3 into this 3 by 2 into 1. The answer is equal to 3 by 2. Generally, the examiner will give problems within 2 to 3 steps you can able to answer. That means there is some logic is there in the problem. If you catch that logic which they are asking the examination, you can answer it very fastly. So by practice only you'll get it, by reading number of examples, by knowing the formulas, you can answer very easily. The problem the examiner intention is here in this by asking this question is what? 1 can be written as 1 cube or not, whether you can able to apply the formula of a cube and b cube or not. Here sin x is there. Sin x can be written as sin x by x. Sin, sin inverse, tan, tan inverse is given to you. Definitely you have to apply the formula. Here I multiplied with x, divided with x, this became 1. Even though this problem in place of x, if you put 0, what I am getting? Cos 0, 1. 0. Even though it is in the form of 0 by 0, I have not applied L-Hospital rule. I have not applied the L-Hospital rule. Why? Because I have not applied the L-Hospital rule. You can apply. You will get answer. It takes more time. Because here again you have to apply. Multiply with the 2. Divide with the 2. 2 sin x cos 2 sin x cos x. Sin 2x. Apply UV formula. It takes more time. The here I have write this one as 1 cube. We have to apply the formula of a cube minus b cube. And sin is there. You should be careful. Sin x by x. Multiply with x and divide with x and apply the limit.